Well, the reports of Libya mobilizing its air force against its own people spread quickly around the world. But Russia's military chief says they've been monitoring from space, and the pictures tell a different story. Well, RT's Irina Galushko can tell us more on this now. Irina, what are they saying?
Well, Alice, at this point, we have information from Russia's joint staff who are saying that they have been monitoring the situation in Libya from space via satellites since the beginning of the unrest in the country. And according to them, some of the reports made by the Western media are not entirely corresponding to the pictures that they are getting. To be more precise, according to Al Jazeera and to BBC, on the 22nd of February, Libyan government has inflicted airstrikes on Benghazi, the biggest city in the country, and on Tripoli. And according to Russia's military, they have not registered any of those air strikes. According to them, the pictures show that nothing of that sort has been going on the ground. Now, if we also focus on the pictures, on the footage that we've been getting from the country, we may be able to notice that there are absolutely no signs of any destruction inflicted by attacks from air or by Libyan Air Force in those pictures. So at this point, Russia's military is saying that as far as they are concerned, they have not seen any attacks, so they can pretty much make a judgment that those attacks which the Western media has been reporting on have not been made. Also,
there are tributes this morning for a Melbourne teacher who drowned while trying to rescue students from a rip at Bells Beach, south of Geelong. Paul Simpson was snorkeling with a group from Caulfield Girls Grammar yesterday when some of them were washed away by large waves. It's believed the 40-year-old was trying to save the schoolgirls when he got into trouble. Tour operators pulled the students from the water, but when they returned for the 40-year-old, he was unconscious and could not be revived. Counselling is being offered to staff and students at the school.
Hello, everyone. Welcome to Global Government News. Today is Saturday, March 5th, 2011. I'm Darko. This is the final part four of this news bulletin for today. I'd like to thank all of you for joining me and for sticking with me through this series of news videos. The last video is my favorite one to make. I was really looking forward to it, so hopefully you enjoyed it. Okay, so we're going to move on here. The cheating epidemic at Britain's universities. A cheating epidemic is sweeping universities with thousands of students caught plagiarizing, trying to bribe lecturers, and buying essays from the internet. And I remember that was going on. I didn't even know it was going on until the teachers were talking about it in college when I was going. And I didn't know you can buy essays off the internet. I never did it. I never had a need for it. I liked using my brain and, basically writing my own stuff. But when I was going through college, I noticed that that's not really how it is. There's very few people in college that I found that actually have some ideals and ideals that they would fight for, you know what I mean? And most of them just want to get the piece of paper and that's it. They don't really want to think too much and whatever, you know what I mean? And it's no surprise though, right? Because I've covered articles where it says university students are their depression rate is on the rise, and also that the statistics for students is for science and math is way down, and so, you know, and they're getting ripped off for what they're doing. It's a complete, I think it's a complete waste of money. I think you can do better off just educating yourself, really. Unfortunately, you can't get a job with a decent job without a high school diploma, the piece of paper that you've been certified, brainwashed by the state, and indoctrinated into this reality, right? So, Texas House passes abortion ultrasound bill without exceptions. The Texas Medical Association has raised concerns about the bill, saying it would interfere with a doctor-patient relationship and allow non-doctors to decide on medical tests. Texas is poised to enact legislation requiring women to undergo a sonogram and to listen to a doctor's description of the fetus before an abortion, following passage of the bill in the state house. And it was voted 103-42. Approve House Bill 15, which, unlike similar measures in the state, does not exempt women who are victims of rape or incest. And moving on here, anti-abortion plans pose dilemma for Republicans. Restrict abortion or cut spending. The Republicans' Pledge for America says the new majority will do both, but negotiations over the federal budget threaten to force the GOP, including its 87 House freshmen, to choose between them. So I don't really know how or why the government funds abortions, but they do. And here we go. Bill to stop federal funding of abortion voted out of committee. The no taxpayer funding for abortion act was voted out of the House Judiciary Committee on Thursday, paving the way for the bill to be taken up by lawmakers on the House floor. Moving forward here, cold winters linked to climate change. I had to do a double take when I read this. I'm like, it's like you read it and you're just like, are you kidding me? Really? Seriously, are you kidding me? Cold winters linked to climate change. Okay, well, yeah, climate change is, it's a changing climate. Well, no. What they're saying is the cold winters are due to human activity, humans driving their cars and having their lights on in their house, emitting CO2. And I will say right off the bat that CO2 does not drive climate. Actually, climate drives CO2 levels. Now, I know that sounds contradictory to everything that you've been and that has been bedded into your brain in school, in grammar school, in high school, and in college, but it's just not so. There are a decent amount of a strong minority of climatologists that agree with the theory that I just mentioned, that the climate itself changes and basically dictates CO2 levels. It's not CO2 levels that dictate climate change. So, and there's been a lot of manipulation of data and statistics, especially with those graphs that they're showing people. And I'm not going to go into it because I just would like to finish up today. You can go in there and you can check out the great global warming swindle, among other things. Stefan Molyneux of Freedom Main Radio has had a couple of interviews with climatologists, and I think that those two videos you'll get a better picture of what's going on there. I'm going to move on here. La Nina induced drought to affect millions. Since November, East African countries have registered serious drought conditions that are likely to worsen in coming months, according to data recently released by the World Meteorological Organization. The La Nina weather effect is largely responsible. And we have this bed bug wave expected for summer, experts says. So I keep hearing about these bed bugs. I don't really read all these stories about these stupid bed bugs, although I did cover an article last time because I just keep hearing it over and over and over again. And I don't think I've ever had a problem with bed bugs. I never knew that they were such a big deal, but maybe they are. I mean, maybe they are a really big deal. And the only thing that I can think of, I mean, right off the bat, of course, is what? Is chemtrails. I mean, they're spraying us with little mini robots, right? They're spraying us with mini robots. They are manipulating the weather. So, by manipulating the weather, they're manipulating the whole ecosystem. So God only knows where these, what is causing this. But it says here, Earth to see sixth mass extinction. The Earth could be on the verge of a sixth mass extinction, which means many animal species might disappear within the next 300 years, a new study finds. EU backs away from 30% emissions target. Leak show says the European Commission will not call for tougher targets on carbon emissions, despite analysis showing doing so would be cost-effective. Ooh, cost-effective for who? For the average slave? I don't think so. It's just going to make it even harder for them so that they die and go away. But, that's the plan. That's the whole purpose. So that's good that they didn't do that. Gillard to talk Afghan and carbon in U.S. So she's not getting what she wants. The Australians don't like the levy tax, and now they're trying to get hit with a carbon tax. Why? Oh, because they got hit by cyclones, and then they gotten hit by floods. And the Australian people are hurting pretty bad, and now they're going to slap a carbon tax on them, which is going to increase all their utility rates, their fuel rates, their food rates, everything. So she's going to run over to the U.S. and say, help me, how do you guys do it? Well, they're not doing it either. They're having a hard time there, too, because people realize it's a big fraud. Agenda 21, Part 3, Maryland County abolishes Agenda 21. Now it's your turn. You can go in there and check that out. It's a good article. It gives a lot of good links and some background on it. Obama speaks at Miami Central High. President Obama, along with former Florida Governor Jeb Bush, made a South Florida appearance to discuss the future of education in the United States. And He spoke about a lesson plan that had been proven to be successful at the former underperforming school that has now made the grade. Because you're doing what I challenged states to do shortly after I took office, and that's turning America's lowest performing schools around. This is something that hasn't received as much attention as it should, but it could hardly be more important to our country. That's right. Indoctrinating and brainwashing young people before they grow up and start thinking for themselves is pertinent to this new world order. And that's why you have philanthropists and eugenicists or bioethicists. He's not really a bioethicist, but he considers himself a philanthropist. I just call him a straight-up eugenics. He wants people to die. He wants less people on the earth, and he'll take out measures and do what he's doing to see that happen. It says here, Bill Gates pushes innovative education reform. So, and he's saying how important it is to have education and how we don't have enough money. So Obama's saying we got to do it, and so is Bill Gates. Dead baby dolphins continue to wash ashore on Gulf beaches. Then we have time to end the insane practice of lacing chicken feed with arsenic. I didn't know that, so you go in there and check that out. Radioactive wastewater found in Pennsylvania drinking water. Then Cuba starts national anti-polio campaign. And how do you think they're going to do that, folks? Cuba started a national polio encephalitis vaccination campaign on Friday, during which 500,000 children will receive the vaccines. This is very sad, guys. Dr. Jonas Salk, inventor of the polio vaccine, exposes criminal-minded scientists who conducted illicit medical experiments on mental patients. Dr. Jonas Salk, one of the gods in the cult of pharmacology and eugenics, a man who is credited with inventing the polio vaccine, has now been exposed as a medical criminal who conducted illegal medical experiments on mental patients. So, and of course, it was in what? A bioethics meeting, right? Because it's a eugenics meeting. And who is he? Well, he was a proponent of eugenics and depopulation, radical depopulation measures. So go ahead there, Cuba, and roll up your sleeves. Call for boys to get HPV vaccine. So there you go. Now it's coming. And here we go. FDA epilepsy drug Topamax increases risk for oral birth defects. So oral birth defects. FDA pulls more than 500 drugs off the market. Big deal. And it says here, oh, let me just follow that up. It is mostly cold medicines and cough, cold, and allergy medicines. And it says here, enlarged heart may have killed Wes Leonard, high school basketball star, made a game-winning shot, and then dropped dead. It's almost as crazy as that story of that girl that had her first kiss and then dropped dead. Then we have juvenile detainee has enlarged heart. Coroner says an autopsy shows a youth who died after collapsing at the Porter County Juvenile Detention Center in Valparaiso had enlarged heart and fluid in his lungs. So a lot of enlarged hearts. I wonder what that is. Is it the ELFs? Is it the growth hormones? Something's not right. Just like that woman that had that speech impediment, and they said what? It was a, what did they say? It was a migraine? First they said it was a stroke because, you know, her hand went numb, which, you know, sounds right, right? Sounds legitimate. But then they said she had a migraine. That's when I knew, you know what, dude? You guys need to come up with a better way to spreading your disinformation, because to me, I mean, I just see it so fast, I just call the bullshit card because I know it's bullshit. Right? That woman did not suffer from a migraine headache. She either suffered from a stroke or, like I said, watched the CBC radio interview and news segment about wireless radio towers, right? And the people that were living underneath them in an apartment, and they started having tingling sensation, pins and needles, and numbness in their hands and their feet. They had migraine headaches, and that's probably what she complained of. She probably complained of pain in her right hand and numbness, and she complained of migraines, all due to these wireless frequencies. So let's just, you know, try to get to the actual facts here and not just, you know, talk about, you know, a bunch of crap that's not going to help anybody. The hidden tyranny, children diagnosed and drugged for profit, and that's just a sad truth, right? Says China's toxic rice program, and they have high levels of cadmium and other toxic heavy metals polluted China's waterways and ended up in the village rice paddies. And they complain of bone pains. Some have stopped eating their own crops, feeding it to livestock, or selling it if they can. And guess what, guys? Not only do they have that, they have now plastic rice. I shit you not. Pardon my French, but they have plastic rice now. GMO plastic rice. Says electronic cigarette dangerous side effects. I knew these things were a scam, guys. Stay away from these things. Just smoke organic tobacco. Roll your own. That's what I do. I enjoy smoking. I smoke six cigarettes a day, and you know, I take my B17, and hopefully I won't have cancer. So stay away from those things if you can. Obama declares state governor will enforce health care bill, whether they like it or not. And lastly, feds charge Jared Lee Loughran with 6 murders. This is GGN and on Darko. Thank you.